The first thing that you do is you take your valuable jewelry and the letters from your mother and the porcelain from your father and the ring from your great aunt, and you put it somewhere safe, not in the house, but you put it somewhere safe. The second thing that you do is you scurry around the house and you look for documents, anything that you can find, and you put it together so that you can prove income, you can prove businesses, you can prove purchases. That's what you do. You get financial bank statements, brokerage statements, IRA, 401k, 403b, deferred compensation plans, anything. And you put it all together and you organize it and you bring it to your lawyer. The other thing that you do is you change your password. You have to change your password because the other spouse knows your password. So change your password so they cannot get into it anymore. And in the old days, the spouses, the wives, kept a little handkerchief, and in the handkerchief she saved money for just in case. Everybody needs to have money just in case something bad happens, and if you're thinking that your marriage is going down the tubes, you need to have safety money. So it is very important that if everything is in joint savings, that you make sure that you take out half. That if there is money in a vault in the house, you make sure that you take out money so that you are safe. You have to document it. You'll have to tell the court about it. But just make sure that you have money under your control. It was called a little pekala. These little old Russian people, they had like little savings, and that's what you need. You need to be able to pay your living expenses. You need to make sure that your Visa and American Express cards don't go unpaid. You need to make sure that your car is paid. You need to keep your credit record great. So you need to be prepared. So when you're thinking or you're worried that the other spouse is going to file against you or you're thinking of filing, you make sure that you have enough safety money to carry you until we get to the courts. Because the court, each judge has thousands of cases and they would like to help you tomorrow, but they can't. So sometimes it takes weeks or maybe even months to get to court. So you need to make sure that you have safety and that you don't jeopardize your financial status, your financial credit cards. That's what you need to do prior to filing for divorce.